It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. So, for this video, I'm gonna talk about a brief breakdown of the Spanish Ministry of Equality. Now, the Spanish Ministry of Equality was first established earlier this year. Of course, Pedro Sanchez, the guy for the president of Spain, chose Irene Moreno as the leader for the Ministry of Equality. However, it seemed as though as soon as she became part of this Ministry of Equality, a lot of stuff really got bad in Spain. Now, before we talk into more detail about what is this Ministry of Equality, I think it's very important to actually have some sort of definition. So, without further hesitation, let's listen to what Moreno had to say about this definition of the Ministry of Equality.
Gracias, Presidenta. Señora Ministra, ¿cuál es la utilidad del Ministerio de Igualdad?
Este ministerio sirve para que todos los españoles y particularmente todas las mujeres, especialmente en los momentos más difíciles, sepan que los que piensan, como ustedes dicen, que la violencia no tiene género, están simplemente fuera de la ley. Muchas gracias.
When that clip first came out, many Spaniards were really upset, and for good reason, about this definition of what defines the Ministry of Equality. Like, when she says that if you are critical of, like, the idea of gender and that you're outside the law for thinking that violence has no gender, many people interpret this as, you see, your ideas are not acceptable, and because your ideas are not acceptable, that means you're not covered underneath the Spanish Constitution. Which, of course, is a humongous violation of free speech. But this is European country that we're talking about, so most of Europe don't have any sort of free speech, and so it's going to be even more sort of like some sort of hate speech approach if they were to apply what she wants to actually do. And not only that, many people were actually upset about her actually saying that in front of like people, but also she did like a really stupid action earlier this year that, of course, potentially have affected millions of Spaniards across the whole entire nation. Of course, I'm talking about the infamous March the 8th sort of protest. Not protest, but rather the march. Now, what happened in Spain on March the 8th is, of course, that millions and millions of Spaniards who were feminists went outside to, of course, have some sort of equal rights gathering. And she was one of the participants that actually took part in that meeting because she is the feminist ministry of equality, and that anything that deals with feminism is very, very important. However, it turns out like a few days later or like a day later after she went to that sort of gathering with feminists that she actually had COVID-19. So she had potentially affected like so many people at that gathering just because she was very irresponsible for her actions. When you have signs out there that literally say that machismo kills more than the coronavirus, of course, naturally, what am I going to expect of a person who prioritizes feminism over the safety of millions of Spaniards across the whole entire nations? And of course, now, Spain is, of course, known for having one of the highest rates of the coronavirus thanks to that irresponsible action. Good job, Ministry of Equality. Now, the whole mantra for, like, you know, the Ministry of Equality is how super feminist it is, how it wants to protect the LGBT rights, how it wants to protect the women's rights. Well, the person behind it, Irene, is actually married to a literal communist who is the vice president of Spain. Of course, I'm talking about Pablo Iglesias. Now, Pablo Iglesias openly admitting of being a communist live on some sort of television station, and he also openly supports people like Che Guevara. And so, when you have that sort of combination, I cannot help but to feel sort of confused about that, because to me, if you support the LGBT rights, if you support women's rights, Why would you support someone like, you know, Che Guevara? Why would you support something like communism? That makes no sense. It makes as much sense as saying, well, you see, I support the rights for African Americans. However, I'm going to join the Ku Klux Klan to show how much I support African Americans. It's really stupid. It's really dumb to think that she teamed up with this little person to actually be like the vice president of Spain. Besides affecting potentially millions of people in Spain with the coronavirus, despite having some sort of husband that openly supports Che Guevara and getting donations from Venezuela to actually fund his campaign, it appears that, of course, when it comes down to the idea of sexual harassment, guess what she considered to be sexual harassment according to her studies? Now, I went to like sites such as El Mundo to get a better idea of what they consider to be sexual harassment, and it turns out that the mere act of looking at a woman is considered to be sexual harassment in Spain, thanks to this crazy woman. Now, of course, when it comes down to this whole entire idea of whether looking at a woman is sexual harassment, that is not really true in the slightest. Is it possible that people could sexualize like how they look at somebody? Absolutely. Like, if you see a girl and you're a guy, sometimes you want to check out her ass. That's a fact. Or sometimes for like females, they want to check out the muscles of a guy or perhaps their cock. That's also possible. However, if you're just having a general conversation with somebody, I don't think that's automatically sexualizing someone for the sake of sexualizing someone. So, the idea that somehow that looking at a woman is some sort of form of harassment in of itself is batshit crazy to me. Back in November, of course, the Minister of Equality wanted to have some sort of speech in regards to women's rights, and so naturally I was curious just how bad the speech went, and it did not disappoint in the slightest.
Llegamos a este 25 de noviembre tras meses intensos de lucha contra las violencias machistas en un contexto duro de emergencia sanitaria, económica y social, habiendo puesto en marcha un plan de contingencia para garantizar los derechos de las mujeres víctimas de violencia de género y también para las mujeres víctimas de trata, de explotación sexual y mujeres en contextos de prostitución. Un plan de contingencia que ha garantizado como esenciales los servicios de atención integral a las mujeres víctimas de estas violencias y que, en coordinación con las comunidades autónomas, entidades locales y organizaciones de la sociedad civil especializadas, ha permitido poner en marcha el primer mecanismo de identificación complementario al policial a efectos socioasistenciales para garantizar los derechos de las mujeres víctimas de explotación sexual, trata y contextos de prostitución. Llegamos a este 25 de noviembre con una mejora y ampliación del servicio 016 en marcha, para que el 016 permita ampliar sus servicios de información y asesoramiento jurídico a todas las víctimas de todas las formas de violencia machista recogidas en el Convenio de Estambul y para que pueda prestar además un nuevo servicio de contención emocional, así como la posibilidad de que todos los servicios sean prestados también por mensajería instantánea. Llegamos a este 25 de noviembre con la tramitación en marcha de la Ley Orgánica de Protección Integral a la Infancia y la Adolescencia frente a la violencia, que incluye, por fin, medidas tan centrales para la lucha contra las violencias machistas como la prohibición del síndrome de alienación parental o la suspensión del régimen de visitas para los maltratadores en los casos de violencia. Llegamos a este 25 de noviembre muy cerca de poder llevar a las Cortes Generales la ley Solo Sí es Sí, la Ley de Garantía Integral de la Libertad Sexual, que coloca en el centro el consentimiento, nuestra voluntad como mujeres, que garantiza la misma red de protección para todas las mujeres víctimas de todas las formas de violencia machista, no solo aquellas que se dan en el ámbito de la pareja o la expareja, que deja muy claro que no es abuso, sino violación.
I find it so curious that somehow the supposed champion for women's rights is actually against prostitution. Now, normally, under normal circumstances, like under the term for abortion, people say, my body, my choice. Well, is that woman's body and that woman's choice if she wants to become a prostitute? Now, the main reason why there are so many abuses across the world when it comes down to prostitution is because there's no sort of safeguards when it comes down to it being illegal. By having prostitution illegal, you create black markets. Sometimes the pimps want to get the prostitutes, and so it puts them in a very dangerous, vulnerable situation. Whereas if you were to legalize prostitution and actually have businesses that are based on that service alone, the woman would be actually happier, the woman would actually be safer, and also to have requirements like testing for STDs and stuff will actually help women not spread any sort of diseases among the clients. And so, if it's really my body, my choice, what would a feminist be against the idea of women having bodily autonomy over sex? That to me does not make no sense. What also does not make any sense is that she wants to support a yes means yes law. Now, this whole entire idea of yes means yes actually started with this book right here, done by an American feminist. Now, in my country, there are some states that do in fact imply the yes means yes law. However, it's also coming towards Spain thanks to that woman. Now, the idea of yes means yes is essentially the idea of, well, they have to say yes every step of the way during sex. However, that's not how people work at all. Like, people can, like, show their consent in a different way than always having to talk all the time. And of course, if you kiss someone and they kiss you, that's one way to show consent. Or if a person says flat out no, of course, obviously that's not consent. So I don't think the mere act of having sex and the person consenting in different ways necessarily need a law like that, because of course people who are like men in Spain, they have like a lot of empty rights when it comes down to those kind of issues. Like, false accusations could put you in jail in Spain, and so why wouldn't it screw men even more so with this sort of law?
Último, un acto que supone una llamada a la unidad, a los pactos de mujeres, a las alianzas feministas. El patriarcado nos quiere en soledad, sintiendo la culpa, la pena, la rabia y el dolor en soledad, incapaces de reconocer las violencias que se ejercen contra nosotras por el simple hecho de ser mujeres, aterrorizadas ante la posibilidad de hablar, de contar, de compartir nuestras experiencias y de juntarnos con otras mujeres para conquistar nuestros derechos. Las mujeres sabemos que solo en común, codo a codo, conseguimos las cosas, y por eso los reconocimientos que hoy entregamos a todas y cada una de vosotras son también un reconocimiento al movimiento feminista, a las redes de mujeres, que son la mano amiga a la que cualquier mujer puede agarrarse para combatir la violencia, que son los espacios seguros para que ninguna mujer en nuestro país se sienta sola. No digo estas palabras con ingenuidad, las digo como una declaración de intenciones. Este es el ministerio de todas las mujeres, de todas las mujeres. Existe gracias al movimiento feminista y es una mano que suma a las manos de millones de mujeres en la defensa de la vida.
I love how she just puts on a show and just cries like that. Like, boo-hoo! Boo-hoo-hoo! Oh my god! It is so hard to be like a woman in Spain. But according to the data, like, women are actually treated way better in Spain in comparison to other countries and European parts. So, it seems as though that, of course, this whole entire thing seems fake to me. All of it seems fake. So, to sum it all up, she doesn't really care much about equality. She seems to be very, very corrupt. And so, when people actually, you know, look up to her, I'm kind of wondering, like, what do people see in her? Because I don't see anything positive from this. All it does is basically install feminism as part of the Spanish government and just try to make everyone's lives miserable. But what do you guys think? Tell me in the comment section down below, and I'll see you guys next time.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.